Friends, here we have finite automata, and our task is to minimize this automata. As this automata are having total 8 number of states, where Q3 is final state and all other are non-final states. Now we are going to minimize this automata. Is there any possibility that it will be minimized? If we will have 7 number of states for the same automata, then we can say that is also minimized. It might be possible that we can design same automata by lesser number of states. Let's first draw transition table for this finite automata so that mapping for alphabets will be easier. So that will help us to design minimized automata. So suppose that this represent alphabets and this represent states. So we are having 0, 1 as alphabets, and total Q0 is initial states, Q1, Q2, Q3 is a final state, Q4, Q5, Q6, Q7. Q0 for 0, it is going to Q1, and for 1, it is going to same state. So in same fashion, we will fill the entry. So in this way, we completed transition table. Now what we have to do? Our first step is to make two different set of state. In one set will final state, in another set will non-final state. So here we have two different set. One is containing Q3, and in one set we are having all non-final states. So now we will look for one equivalence. Q3 will not be partitioned because there are only single element in this set, so Q3 will as it is. Now try to partition this set. How we will partition? Suppose that for Q0, for 0 it is going to Q1 or in the same set, or Q0 for 1 it is going to the Q0. It means that Q0 is representing same set. Those states will be partitioned if those sets will representing another set. So here we are having only two sets. Those sets will be in the another class if for any alphabets are representing these sets. So as Q0 we checked, we will check for Q1. Here we can see that Q1 for 0 going to Q0 and for 1 going to Q2. So there is no problem. For Q2, for 0 it is going to Q3, and for 1 it is going to Q1. Yeah, so there is a problem. So Q2 for 0 it is transition to Q3, or Q3 representing different sets. So here we have to separate Q2. Similarly, we will check Q4 also going to Q3 for 0 alphabets. So once again we have to separate, because we know that Q0 and Q1 are one equivalent, as both the states are representing same sets. But Q0, Q1 with Q2 are not equivalent, or Q0, Q4 are not equivalent, because Q0 representing these sets and Q4 representing different sets. Similarly, we will check Q5. So Q5 representing Q6 for 0 or same sets, or for 1 it is representing Q4. So there is no any problem. Similarly, we will check for Q6 also. So Q6 for 0 it is going to Q5, which is in the same sets, and for 1 it is going to Q6. So there is no problem. For Q7 it is going to Q6, and for 1 it is going to Q3. So there is a problem. So we are having Q2, Q4 and Q7 are in different sets than other states. So here we will have Q0. Here these all are will be in the same sets. Now we will have to check for Q2, Q4 and Q7. So Q2 for 0 going to Q3, Q4 Q4 for 0 going to Q3 and Q7 for 0 is going to Q6. So there we will say that Q2 and Q4 are one equivalent, but Q2 and Q7 or Q4 and Q7 are not one equivalent. So that we will make Q2 and Q4 in the same set and Q7 will be in different sets. Similarly, we will calculate two equivalent or second equivalent. Now friends, we will check for further partition. So here once again we have only single element, so there is no need to partition. Now here we will have to check, just check for Q0. For alphabet 0 it is going to Q1 or Q1 representing the same set, so there is no problem for 0, and for 1 it is going to Q0. So Q0 is for alphabet 0 and 1 representing the same set. Just check for Q1. For 0 it is going to Q0 and for 1 it is going to Q2. But there is a problem with Q1. It is representing these sets for alphabet 1. Similarly for Q5, this is going to Q6 for 0, or Q6 is in the same set, and Q5 is going to Q4 for 1. It means that Q5 is also representing these sets for 1. It means that Q1 and Q5 are two equivalent. Check for Q6. For 0 it is going to Q5, or Q5 is in the same set of states, and for 1 it is representing Q6, or Q6 is in the same set. It means that Q0 and Q6 will be separated by Q1 and Q5. So here we have Q0 and Q6, and Q1 and Q5 are two equivalent as we have seen. Now check for Q2 and Q4. Q2 for 0 going to Q3 or final states, and Q4 is also going to final states, so there is no problem for 0 alphabets. Now we will check for 1. Q2 for 1 is going to Q1 or representing these sets, and Q4 for 1 is going to Q5 or these sets, so there is no problem. So this will not be further partition, and Q7 are having a single element in these sets, so there is no possibility of partition. Similarly friends, we will get three equivalents. So as we have discussed, there is no chance of partition of Q2 and Q4, but we have to check for this and this. So Q3, just we look for partitioning of Q0 and Q6. So check here, Q0 for 0 is going to Q1 or representing these sets, and Q6 is representing Q5. So for 0 it is going to the same set. Just check for another alphabets. Q0 is going to Q0 or representing same sets, and Q6 is going to Q6. So there is a no possibility of breaking or partitioning this set. So this will be as it is. Just check for Q1 and Q5. For 0 it is going to Q0. So it is going to Q0 or these sets. Q5 for 0 is going to Q6. So for 0 there is no problem. Just we will check for another alphabets. Q1 for 1 is going to Q2 and Q5 is going to Q4. So Q2 and Q4 are representing same sets. Once again, there is no need or no possibility of partitioning the sets. And Q2 and Q4 earlier we have checked, okay, there is no chance of breaking. So finally we can say that two equivalence and three equivalence are equal. So here we have to stop. So total number of sets 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So friends, all sets are representing different states. Let's say first set is A, second is B, this is C, this is D, and this is E. So which state will be final state and which state will be initial state? So friends, here we had Q3 as final states, so Q3 is here. So A will be our final state. Now check for initial state. Q0 was initial state. So where is Q0? So where is the Q0? So B will be our initial state. So our next task is to represent or to draw transition table using 5 steps. Friends, let's draw transition table using new states. So our initial state is Q0, Q6. So write it like this. For 0, it is going to, so just check for both the states. So Q0 for 0 going to Q1, so return Q1. And Q6 for 0 going to Q5, so return Q5. And we know that Q1 and Q5 are separate states. Similarly, for 1, Q0 is going on same states and Q6 on going on the same states. So that we can say that Q0 and Q6. Similarly, we will feed the entry Q1 and Q5. So Q1 is going for 0 on the Q0 states and Q5 for 0 going to Q6 states. And this is the same states. So in same fashion, we have to complete the transition table. Friends, so we completed the entry. Let's check here for Q3. For 0, it was representing the same states. For 1, it is representing Q0. And we know that Q0 is not a separate state. So we had to write Q0 and Q6. In same way, for Q7, for 0 alphabets, it is representing Q6. So we have to write here Q0, Q6. And for 1, it is representing Q3. So this is our complete transition table. Now we can draw minimized finite automata using this table. So what will be the states? So our Q0, Q6 is initial state. For 0, for 1 it is going to Q0, Q6. Now Q1, Q5 for 0 it is going to, and for 1 it is going to Q2, Q2, Q4 for 1 is going to Q3, and for 1 it is going to here only. Q3 for 0 is going to not, and for 1 it is going to here. Q7 for, suppose that here, for 0 it is going to here, and for 1 it is going to here. So this is our transition diagram or minimized transition diagram of finite automata. Hope you understand the concepts of minimization. In next video, watch another problem solving session. If you understand the concepts, then you can like and subscribe my channel. Still you are facing problem to understand, then also comments. Thank you.